So, Mother's Day was a couple of weeks ago, at least here in America. It's a splendid day where you tell your mother how much you love her, have a nice brunch with the fam, and of course, get her some flowers. But here's the thing. My mom has recently gotten into planting and floral arrangements. I mean, she's really into plants. And I think you can see my issue here. More flowers would just add clutter to the slightly smaller version of the Singaporean flower dome we have growing in our house. But then it came to me. I'll grow her a plant, virtually. Arguably one of the trickier moves in Blender, and surely the most ubiquitous. Let's see how I delete this cube. Fantastic. So a pot is a pretty simple thing to model from a cylinder. All I had to do was make a smaller bottom, a brim, and hollow it out. Right here, you can see that I had trouble hollowing out the entire pot, so I really only hollowed out the brim area and kind of gave up. Don't say thank you, oh please, I do. Here we can see my multiple attempts at making a flower petal. First I tried flattening a cylinder and shaping it, but I didn't like the look very much. Then I tried making a circle into an ellipse and giving it volume, but I couldn't figure out how to add a loop cut in the middle to give it a natural bend. I even dabbled with Bezier curves to see if that would work, but my Blender skills were clearly not up to par. So change of plans. I decided to use this one for inspiration instead. What we have here is a UV sphere that is cut in half and then cut in half again. If my calculations are correct, that's 1/4 of a sphere. But feel free to double check me on that. An array modifier for duplication and a simple deform modifier for that circular orientation, and boom, we have something. Maybe you don't see it, but when we bring the pot back and start piecing this thing together, it starts to look a little better, right? I know, it's not exactly like the reference plan, and I know it kind of looks like an artichoke, but that's why it's called reference, right? Whatever. Tough guy, like you really rough guy, just can't get enough. So first I imported an HDRI environment to get some realistic lighting, and then I started experimenting with colors for the plant. I wasn't going for realism here, and my mom likes pink, so I settled on that. Then I switched to an anisotropic BSDF, which gave it a nice metallic look. Again, not going for realism. Obviously. I really liked the look of gradient backgrounds, and so I was seeing which two colors would suit the plant best. Inverting the plant and pot colors ended up giving a nice, subtle contrast. I forgot to record myself making the Lazy Susan, but you can find the video I used to procedurally create a wood texture in the description below. I did not figure that out myself. Finally, an area light to give it some extra definition, and boom, we're looking good. Duh. Since I committed to a virtual gift, I had to accompany it with a virtual card. I aligned two planes together like so, and shrink wrapped some text onto the front side. All that was left was to animate the Lazy Susan to rotate in a circle, and looks like we're coming to a finished product.